In this video, we'll show you how we use Navigraph on our Xbox console and how to enhance your flight simulation experience with the help of you, the community.
And in this video, we'll also explain what we're currently offering and what we're working on to enhance the simulation experience on Xbox.
This tutorial is based on staff experience combined with the feedback and suggestions from our users. You are an invaluable source of inspiration and motivation for us. So thank you so much for your attention and participation.
Right, so back in 2022, we did a video showcasing the first aircraft with the Navigraph Charts integration on Xbox, which was the HGS from Flight Effects.
Yeah, and that was a long time ago, even before I even started working at Navigraph. I was actually simming in my living room on an Xbox Series X using a Velocity 1 with a stand. For me, having a Navigraph subscription was all about learning aircraft navigation, reading charts, and putting together everything in a single flight.
So since the release of the Flight Effects HJet, not only the list of supported add-ons has grown, but also the functionality has been expanded. And we're currently getting loads of questions on where we're at when it comes to our services in relation to the Xbox platform.
Yes. So in relation, let's talk about charts. How are we in charts on Xbox?
We offer worldwide maps for VFR and IFR, as well as the Jeppesen electronic charts library available for thousands of airports across the globe. Now, the maps and charts can be displayed on our standalone charts app, which is available on most devices and even in browsers. We also work closely with third-party add-on aircraft developers who integrate our charts into the virtual cockpit environment for a more immersive experience. Now, several aircraft are available on the Xbox platform today with the charts integration, and the list is constantly growing. On Microsoft Flight Simulator for PC, you can see your current aircraft position in the charts app and get additional data as well of your flight. Now, for Xbox, this functionality is currently available in third-party add-ons that use the Navigraph Avionics plugin.
Exactly. And all of this will be shown to you later in this video. But what about flight planning?
Right, so we offer a freeware software for flight planning called SimBrief. And what's really cool with SimBrief is that you can create a very detailed and realistic IFR flight plan using this software. Basically, you won't get any closer to the real deal when it comes to flight planning.
And he's a pilot, so he knows what he's talking about.
So similar to the charts, we support third-party add-on aircraft developers who integrate SimBrief functions, such as viewing an operational flight plan, the OFP, and importing flight plans into the aircraft. Now, although the number of aircraft currently supported on Xbox are fewer than on PC, this list is also growing.
Cool. And what about navigation data then?
Right, so a navigation data update service that we provide to PC users ensures that airports, procedures, waypoints, and so on match the maps and charts that we provide. The Jeppesen dataset is also the most comprehensive of its kind, and although we're currently not offering this for Xbox, we are in a test and evaluation phase for navigation data updates on Xbox that we're working with third-party developers on.
Really exciting news. We know the Xbox community is growing and that the demand for more applications is increasing as well.
Yeah, and we hear your requests and ideas, and our developers are exploring new ways to bring the complete Navigraph experience to the Xbox platform.
So Andy, we'll be talking about third-party add-ons now, but what about the default aircraft on Xbox?
Right, so we're not yet able to target those with charts integration or navigation data, because on Xbox those would need to be distributed via the marketplace. We hope to be able to publish our product on the Xbox marketplace in the future, and in the meantime, we'll continue to work closely with third-party add-on developers. And if you want to know which add-on aircraft we support and how we support them, just head over to our Xbox page and we'll make sure that there's a link in the description below for that.
This is how we recommend flying on Xbox for a convenient experience. We highly recommend using a mouse to navigate menus and the cockpit smoothly and efficiently.
Right, and as a next step, a yoke and a throttle will give you a more realistic experience.
We use a Velocity 1 controller from Turtle Beach. However, there are peripherals from other popular manufacturers such as Thrustmaster. As promised earlier in the video, I will now show you how to set up the FSR 500. This is one of currently three aircraft that uses the Navigraph avionics plugin on Xbox. The setup process will be similar for other add-ons that use the avionics plugin, and all the step-by-step instructions on how to set up the integration for a specific aircraft can be found at blog.navigraph.com. Let's go to settings. You need to authenticate and connect your Navigraph subscription to the FSR 500. You need to do this by activating charts, connecting your SimBrief with your username, and by activating SimBrief to allow to send flight plans to the G1000. First, let's activate charts. Scan this QR code with your phone or tablet and follow the instructions. Now you're good to go. You have connected your Navigraph charts with the EFB. Let's type in our location and see what happens. Now let's go to the ground charts and take a look at the airport. Here you can see an overview of Arlanda and where we're standing in the runway. And as you can see, the Navigraph charts are now connected to the EFB. Over to SimBrief, let's punch in your username to allow SimBrief to be connected to the EFB. The last step is to allow SimBrief to send your flight plan to the G1000. Let's go over to the G1000 to authenticate and connect your Navigraph charts to the G1000. With the inner knob, highlight navigation and map. With the outer knob, choose IFR VFR charts. Now scan the QR code with your phone or tablet and follow the instructions. As you can see, you have successfully connected Navigraph charts with your G1000. Now let's try to import a SimBrief flight plan. We go back to the EFB, down to flight plan, and click on import from SimBrief. As you can see, the flight plan has been imported to your EFB. But let's see if the G1000 has the flight plan as well. And just like magic, your flight plan directly imported from SimBrief. And finally, let me walk you through the process on how to enable moving maps on your FSR 500 and FS50 Vision Jet. Moving maps allow you to see your position when logged into your Navigraph account in charts on external devices. Let's start with the Vision Jet. In your MFD's home screen, press Utilities, go to Setup, click on Navigraph Chart Settings, and go to SimLink. Now you can easily activate or deactivate the Send Position feature. On the FSR 500, simply navigate to the AUX menu using the inner knob on your G1000 NXI. Select Navigraph Settings under the AUX menu. From there, you will be able to enable or disable SimLink moving maps.
We hope this video has addressed most of your questions, if not all, but also provided you with sufficient information to maybe try out our services. If you go for the unlimited subscription, you'll have access to all our services.
Yeah, and the subscription can be selected on a monthly or yearly basis and can be canceled at any time.
Exactly. We have also gathered some important links in the description below on how to get more information and especially how to get in touch with our development and support departments. Please let us know your thoughts in the comments field.
All right, there we have it. Until next time, happy flying.
Happy flying.